In this clip, we're going to talk about present perfect for IR verbs like recibir, to receive. Okay? Now, I'm going to say the following five phrases in English, then Spanish, and then clap. And after I clap, I'd like you to repeat just the Spanish with me. Here we go. Number one, I have received. Yo he recibido. Yo he recibido. Number two, you have received. Tú has recibido. Tú has recibido. Number three, he has received. Él ha recibido. Él ha recibido. Number four, we have received. Nosotros hemos recibido. Nosotros hemos recibido. And number five, they have received. Ellos han recibido. Ellos han recibido. Now I want you to notice, for present perfect AR, we chopped off the AR and added adio, adio, adio. This is an IR verb, recibir. So you chop off the IR and add idio, idio, idio. We keep our letter. Now I want you to notice, it never changes. It's never IDA, it's never IDAS. It's always, you chop off the IR and add IDO, which makes sense because in English it's ED, 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 ED. Now be careful. I had trouble with this when I was in Spanish. I have received sounds past tense. I received is past tense. But I have received is present perfect. Now, have starts with an H. I have, you have, he has, we have. H, 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 H. And notice, these all start with H. I have A, you have us, he has A, we have hemos, they have on. So the have part starts with an H and the received ends in IDO. All right, let's look at another pattern. Notice, it's E on top of the blue line, it's E on top of the blue line, but it's A under the blue line. Think of this blue line as being water. The letter E is floating on top, the letter E is floating on top, but the letter A is heavy, so these bottom three sank, us, ah, on. So I call this a sinking verb, okay? Now, if you're thinking, wow, that feels vaguely familiar, right. Let's look at the verb estar. Estar, nobody else calls these verbs sinking verbs. That's something I made up. But estar is what I call a sinking verb. Notice, estoy is on top of the water. Estamos is on top of the water. But this heavy accent caused these bottom three to sink. Estás, está, and están. So it's a sinking verb. Tener. Tengo, the letter E is floating on top of the water. Tenemos, the letter E is floating on top. But if you add another letter, IE is heavy, so it sank. So, estar is a sinking verb because of the accent. Tener is a sinking verb because of the extra letter. And present perfect, it's E's above the water, and the A-S-A-A-N sank. All right, this has been present perfect for IR verbs like recibir.